You all scared off the competition, huh?
I don't know. Are you baiting me into something, Haley?
Huh? Always.
Are you baiting me into something?
Always, always.
I don't think that's the case.
All right.
He's just giving us a sporting chance.
He's just giving us a chance.
Okay.
He's giving us a chance for two wins today so he can try and get two tomorrow.
As far as I'm concerned, two W's is two W's.
There you go. Say anything?
Well, I hope we go all the way down the racetrack this time.
I do too. That'd be a plus.
Yep, it would be, and I firmly believe we'll hopefully see the second side-by-side fives.
Awesome.
That's what I think.
Awesome.
Other than that, I'm waiting for instruction from the big man.
Come down and do these three match races. It was really exciting. We had a great time. You know, Larry's had some bad luck, but as you know, Larry's my mentor. He's my riding coach. And, you know, he had a bit of a bad luck. We had, on the other hand, had a stellar weekend. Three fives in a row. So the 592, I believe, was pretty exciting. Last night, the 589 was incredible.
Did it feel incredible?
It was a little shaky. It wasn't the cleanest pass. I think you said yourself it was probably one of the ugliest fives you've seen.
Well, and, actually, it was the pass before that that was the ugliest. This one started out that way,
right?
And then it straightened itself up. I thought you chopped the throttle.
I did.
Okay.
Probably about mid-track. You probably noticed maybe the flames went down.
Yeah, completely. Yep.
And, you know, the bike was wandering around a little bit, and I sort of needed to gather it up, and there was just no way to do that while it was charging, so I had to let off a little bit, you know, regain my composure and get back into it. So that's why I was especially surprised that the 89 came up, because...
You and me both.
Right. So I was just hoping it was going to be maybe a high five or a low six. So when the guys showed up in the golf cart, I heard it beeping coming up the return lane, and that usually only happens when good things happen.
Right.
And so so that was amazing. The 237 also pretty cool. I think that was our first. We were at 201 miles an hour at the eighth. So I think that's my first pass over 200 at the eighth mile.
Nice. Very nice. So you didn't really get to have any good side-by-side opportunities this weekend. Is that a little disappointing?
It was very disappointing. In fact, I told Larry, it's just wasn't nearly as much fun without him in the other lane. Of course, if you're going to win, you want it to be, you know, right at the stripe by, you know, a half a bike or whatever. So, you know, it was a little anticlimactic. I was happy with the runs, of course, but, you know, you really can't measure yourself against somebody, you know, when you're having some issues. So, yep, very disappointing. But, you know, I guess a W is a W, as they say.
All right, so, got a race in November.
Yeah.
That seems like a long time off, but.
Yeah, well. You know,
we all do anything to stay sharp as a team, or
we'll go up to Canada, where the bike lives at the Pollards, and we'll get it all ready and cleaned up and service the clutch and transmission. We did hit a motor, so that'll go back with Larry, have him freshen that up and bring it to Valdosta with him. I think after those, I'm feeling pretty good, you know, after three fives in a row going into Valdosta, you know, the track's there like it is here, I think we got something for him.
Right.
So,
you had said when you first started riding this bike that it was actually easier to ride in some ways than the Pro Mod because of the long wheelbase and it felt like a more stable ride.
Yeah.
Those two passes yesterday, did that start to feel more like a Pro Mod to you?
Yeah. Well, based on yesterday, it's a lot harder to ride than a Pro Mod. That's for sure. I got the McBrides came over, and I thought it was a tune-up. You know, we brought the clutches in a lot more aggressively. What we didn't do was bring the ship light in as well. I use a ship light on my bike. Nobody else does.
Right.
Because they've been doing it a long time. I needed a little assistance as a new guy. And apparently, if you miss your ship point and you're late, when the bike goes one-to-one, that's how that happened. So I guess it was self-inflicted. But no, it's as we progress, I'll probably have to retract my Pro Mod statement that, because as we go faster. The fueler is definitely, it's basically finesse versus bull riding.
Can you explain that one-to-one?
Well, when the transmission and the clutch come together so that you have a one-to-one drive, then it's all in. Instead of slipping the clutch and having the clutch come in, once it goes locks up one-to-one, and if you're still in low gear, apparently bad things happen. So I knew enough once that started happening to hit second gear, and you know it settled down and took off.
Very good.
Yeah. Well, again, I'd like to thank the Pollards for this opportunity. Greg and Stephanie Pollard, just an amazing opportunity, and working with Larry. So again, I want to thank the McBrides. And all the good employees back at Vantine Imaging that allowed me to come out here and do this.
It was good seeing so many employees at ATCO.
It was nice to see everybody in ATCO. You said it yourself. It's turned out to be an annual, such as it was. Of course, we had a little break because we don't run there anymore. Fortunately, yes. So maybe we will again moving forward. Hopefully, the MIROCK series will have us back again. I think mission accomplished, but of course, that's up to Jason.
Well, Right. Well, hey, congratulations. It's been a blast watching the
Tim, always a pleasure.
Watching the team progress.
Thank
and you.
Yeah, well, we're trying. Doing the best we can.
Yeah, good stuff.
Thank you.